CalHFA Short Sale Success. Hey, Mike Rigley, Certified Default Advocate, Distressed Property Expert, and Short Sale Specialist here. Let me start by saying the CalHFA programs are great programs. They have helped thousands of homeowners get into their first home, and through the Keep Your Home California program, have kept thousands more stay in their home. They offer principal reductions, money to help you make your payments while you're unemployed, money to help you catch up on your payments, and if all else fails and you short sale or foreclose, up to $5,000 in relocation assistance. So good programs. We've personally referred quite a few of our friends, family, and clients over to the Keep Your Home California programs. In fact, we even have a video series on it that you can see on our YouTube channel. So they're great programs if you qualify. Now, short sale, a little more difficult with CalHFA. We just recently completed a short sale for a young family that had a CalHFA back loan. Because they had chosen not to accept the loan modification, the servicer was, to say the least, a little reluctant to review the file for short sale. The truth of the matter was, the young family had outgrown the property. A little two-bedroom house, it was beautiful, but they had two kids who were planning on having more. To top it off, they also owned twice what the home was worth, with really no chance of ever owning the home. They had made the conscious decision they were either going to short sale or go ahead and let the property be foreclosed on. They stopped making their payments in October. By February, they had received their notice of default with an anticipated auction sale date of May 30th. Because they'd been approved for a loan modification, the servicer would not review the file. Our file was declined not once, not twice, but three times before the servicer decided we were not going to give up and agreed to review the file. Now, CalHFA is no different than any other investor. While their guidelines are strict, it's still about mitigating their loss. Where will they lose the least amount of money? Will they lose more on a short sale or a foreclosure? In this case, the data was overwhelmingly in favor of the short sale. After 122 days of negotiations, now remember, our average negotiating to approval is about 42 days, so three times that. After 122 days, our short sale was approved, and we closed escrow 30 days later. This was a true testament to our persistence and refusal to accept no for an answer. It just really made financial sense for all parties involved, the homeowner, the servicer, and CalHFA, to accept the short sale. The result, another homeowner was saved from foreclosure, and through the Keep Your Home California program, they were able to get $5,000 in relocation assistance. To get a better idea of when your home will be worth what you owe, log in to www.shortsaleandloanmod.info for a free estimate, or call me today for a free, no-obligation consultation. You'll call me today, you'll sleep better tonight, you'll be glad you did. Thanks for joining us.